Hi, welcome to Konik Solutions YouTube channel. My name is Vishu Agarwal and today I'm going to explain you how to add events in the animation. So while you are animating game objects within Unity, you have an option to add events on a particular frames or seconds, you can say, to perform a certain function. So I have Unity open in front of me. So in this scene, we just have one camera and one queue. So in this queue, I'm going to add an animation and then add the event while the animation is running. So I'm going to go to the animation panel over here and I'm going to create an animation for this cube, which will be moving from left to the right position. So let me just create. I'm going to name it as move and done. So I'm going to add the properties over here. I just want to animate the position. I'm going to add the position properties over here. And let me also increase the duration of the animation by just moving the keyframes. Add in the time. So around 150. That should be fine. So let me just record it. And go to the other side of the keyframes, so last keyframes, and I'm going to move to the right hand side like that. Now you can see it's animating from left to the right, and that's it. So I just don't want to record the further animations. I'm going to stop the recording for the animation or the auto key and go to the 1 second. At this point I want to add an event. So I can see here in the animation panel, you have an option to add event to the animation, which is known as animation events. But currently you don't have any functions to call up here. So what you need to do is you need to create a script. So I have a blank script already made over here, which is cube. So it's currently blank. It does not have any functions inside it, not even start and update. And I'm going to take two functions here. First, I'm going to create my own boolean. I'm going to name it boolean move, which will be by default set to false. And I'm going to create my own function. I'm going to say void. Move to rotate. And over here, I'm just going to make the move bool to true. Here and then I'm going to call the update function. So I'm going to say void update, and here I'm going to just rotate this game object which we have. So I'm going to say game object dot transform dot rotate in the x-axis. I'm going to just give it 0. In the y-axis, I'm going to give it a value of 120 by time dot delta time, and then in the z-axis I'm going to just say 0f and I'll put it over here. Now I'm just going to save the script and go back to Unity. Wait for Unity to compile this script. Once this is compiled, I will apply it to the cube. So I can simply click and drag the script to this cube object which we have. Once done, I can simply go back to the animation panel and select this event. So if you select this event, you will see now in the functions drop down, you will see move to rotate. So I'm just going to select that. And there is something which I have missed in my script, is the move to be called in the update method. So I'm going to say if move is true. So I'm going to now check the condition. If the move is true, then the function will be performed. So I'm going to save this and go back to my project. One last thing which I want to do to my clip is the clip animation which we have, I just don't want to loop it. Also, when you create the animation within Unity, you automatically get an animator and a clip of animation in your project. And this animator is automatically applied to the game object on which you are doing the animation, which basically calls the clip over here. So let me play back and let's see whether it rotates or not. So at frame after 1 second, it should start rotating while it's animating ahead. So let's play. So you can see in the game object when it plays, and after certain time it starts moving. And if I want to stop it, I can even stop it. So after 1 second, you will see that when it reaches half of it, it start slipping and then rotating to it, because the update function is been called because the condition gets true by the event. So that's it. I hope you understood what animation event does. Thank you for watching.